Hello students of class 7th standard, today we will discuss the energy. That chapter I have already finished, you have already learned that chapter. So few revision part I am telling, some main important part I am telling you today, and the question answer, then thereafter I will just discuss. Then first of all, the energy, when you will just read on this chapter, so first of all you have to read what is actually the energy. So basically we have already learned that one. What is that? That is the capacity of doing work. Okay, so how much capacity of doing work? Okay, so basic example is that one. If you have any doubt on that one, that I am trying to just rectify, and that I will just try to clarify to you, that suppose a mass is kept in a particular place. Okay, now suppose one person came and just tried to just push that one. That person was unable to just push that one, shift that particular mass from one place to other place. But you came maybe and you just pushed it, and that particular body has just displaced a few amount. Okay, few displacement you are getting in this case. So definitely you have to tell that that first person has not done any work, but you have done the work. Why? Because you have just given the displacement to the body, but the first person has not able to give the displacement to the body. But if you ask the question that energy for the first person and energy for second person, that means you maybe, where the energy is zero or energy is present everywhere in these two cases or not? Definitely energy is present for both the cases. For the first person also energy is present, for second person energy is also present, but this energy is not sufficient to do this much of work, but this amount of energy is sufficient to just shift the body or do the work. Okay, so energy in that particular sense, energy cannot be zero anytime. That means energy should be present. Either it will be available or it will be able to do the work or not, that depends how much energy present on a particular body. If you have that sufficient amount of energy to lift the body, to shift the body, to give the displacement, to do the work, then definitely you are able to do the work. Otherwise you are not able to do the work. But that doesn't mean that you don't have any type of energy in your body. So that is actually capacity of doing work. Means definitely if you have done the work, then definitely your how much energy you have given to do the work, that will be the actual calculation of energy. Okay, do you have the capacity to do the work? Definitely then you will get the work done. If you don't have the capacity to do the work, then you will definitely don't get the work done. So these two things, work and energy, are very much related to each other. Okay, that is very much related to each other. Okay, so this is the actual thing, that is actually the energy. Next one, while you will just talk about the units and interconversion, that part is also present in your chapter. So unit, suppose when the units if you talk about, then energy and work very much similar to each other. Most familiar unit is actually the joule. Okay, joule is a one unit of energy. You can write down arg also. This is in SI system. This energy, this is the unit of energy in SI system. This unit is in the CGS system. Okay, we all know that CGS and SI system, you have already learned that one in class 6 standard. So these two are the units of energy. Sometime in just in case of explanation of heat is also one type of energy, that I have already told in the previous video, that what is actually the heat and what is actually the temperature. Heat is one type of energy and temperature is actually the calculation or the measurement. Okay, one time you can tell that heat is one type of cause. Okay, and the temperature, while you will talk about, then this is the effect. Okay, so this is cause and second one is the effect. That means this one is, because of this one, temperature is just develops, you can tell that one. Okay, while you will calculate our body temperature with the help of thermometer, then definitely you have to tell some amount of heat energy is present on our body. That's why temperature generates. That is the actual calculation. Suppose the human body temperature during the fever time may be 104 degree. Okay, 104 degree temperature, now this much fever is there. This is actually the calculation of the temperature, not the calculation of heat only. But this temperature is only coming because of this one. Okay, so this particular thing is one type of energy. You can tell that one. So definitely while you will express that one, this unit, suppose if you want to just write of unit of heat, then that is actually calorie in simple form. This is CAL. This is a shortcut method to write that one. This is the conventional method. You can just write down anytime, anywhere, this type of calorie unit while we will discuss this heat energy. Now the definition of one calorie of heat is very much important in your chapter. And that question is repeatedly asked in the exam so many times in the question papers. You can see that one. Calorie of heat means here we will just discuss that the rise in temperature 1 degree centigrade. How much? 14.5 degree centigrade to 15.5 degree centigrade. Okay, 14.5 to 15.5, that means here the change is only 1 degree centigrade. While you will just talk about the rise in temperature of 1 degree, definitely just think for a moment, definitely you have to give heat to rise the temperature. If you not give the heat, definitely the temperature will not rise. So how much heat you have given? 1 calorie. That is only the definition. To just increase the heat from 14.5 to 15.5, how much heat is needed? 1 calorie heat is needed. So that is only the definition. To rise the temperature from 14.5 degree centigrade to 15.5 degree centigrade, how much heat is required? That is only the 1 calorie. Now question in higher classes you will read. Suppose if you talk about this rise, how much rise? 1 degree centigrade. Why not we have started from 1 degree centigrade to 2 degree centigrade? Why not we have started it is from 3 degree centigrade to 4 degree centigrade? Everywhere 1 degree change. Why not that definition is actually 1 calorie? Suppose I am just telling you that suppose from 1 degree centigrade to 2 degree centigrade rise in temperature, the amount of heat needed is 1 calorie. If you tell, then that is a wrong statement. Okay, same here also. If you tell that from 3 degree centigrade to 4 degree centigrade temperature 1 calorie heat is required to rise, that is not actually correct, because in the higher classes you will read that one. This particular, this actually due to specific heat, one term is there. Just don't ask what is that. Okay, in higher classes you will read that one for specific heat. For that reason this particular difference is taken in our consideration. Okay, so that is only the heat and calorie all about. Next, so many interconversions. Before that, law of conservation of energy is also there. Law of conservation of energy, that means energy cannot be created, energy cannot be destroyed, but we can able to change the energy from one particular form to the other form. If you talk about the kinetic energy to potential energy and vice versa, that means from potential to kinetic energy in this form, then definitely you have not created any type of energy. Or you don't have also not created any type of, not destroyed any type of energy. What you have done? You have just interchanged the form. That is only the kind, that is only the law of conservation of energy. Suppose a body is kept in a table. Okay. Definitely it will have the potential energy due to the rest. You have not given anything here. Suppose if you want to lift the body upward, or if you want to shift the body forward or backward, then the definitely kinetic energy will arise due to the motion of the body. Okay, so due to that motion, definitely kinetic energy is just arise. What you have done, just think for a moment, you have only changed the form, potential to kinetic. If you stop the body here, then definitely again the potential energy will come. So what you have now done, from kinetic to potential interconversion you have only made here, nothing else. You have not created potential energy, you have not created kinetic energy, you have not destroyed potential energy, you not have destroyed the kinetic energy. Okay, that is only the law of conservation of energy here. So, so many conversions are there. So, you try to read that one. In the, I will just tell you that in the next video, this one, the question answers, few doubts are there. If you have any doubt, you frequently can ask me the question in the comment section. So, you ask me, I will give you the answer. Okay.